welcome to pdfsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing a 1785 BCM backup communication module, or modules. I have two here. The test will be basically testing the module's ability to pick up if one fails. So if this rack fails, which is currently in primary, then this rack or backup communication module should pop into the primary position and take over, and vice versa. This way I know that they're able to pick up when they're supposed to, number one, and number two, that both modules are communicating with each other. And if probably have a little bit of troubleshooting, maybe a couple problems that I see in the field. So right now, the way I have this set up is I have my parallel wiring between the two BCMs, and I also have my wiring going to my channel 1A and channel 1B on the processors. I have two racks set up as just my test lab here. This is probably a smaller version of what you have in the field, but there are two 1771 A1B four-slot chassis. They're being powered by 1771 P4S power supplies. And the processors are 1785 L20B Series E. They're both L20B Series E. They don't have to be. If you in the field, you may have an L20 on one side and an L40 or 60 or 80 on the other side. It doesn't matter. What's important is that they're both communicating on the same data highway address. That's one tip for you. So now that the system is up and running and it is in remote run mode for this test procedure, I want to simulate a power failure on my primary rack. Now that's important. It must be on the primary rack to make sure that the secondary rack moves itself into primary and knows what to do and when to do it. I'm going to do that by shutting the power off. So please follow. This light here should move to primary when I shut this off. And it has. It's exactly what I want to see. Similarly, when I turn this power back on, my rack that was my primary should jump into secondary. And it has. I've turned it back on, and if you can see at the tip of my finger here, this LED has moved itself into the secondary position. So these two modules know exactly what they're supposed to be doing. And to even further the test, I'll simulate a power failure on this side by shutting this down now. And my rack on the left has jumped into primary. So a little bit of back and forth there, but this is telling me that these two processors are communicating properly. They're doing what they're supposed to be doing when they're supposed to do it. Okay, so a couple of common failures I see in the field, a little bit of troubleshooting, is somebody may have changed the information that's in the processor and it's not communicating properly. So some of the troubles we see range anything from communication to module failure. And you usually see at the tip of my finger there's a FLT, that's the fault light, and it'll turn red if you have a problem. And like I said, it could be anything ranging from a communication failure or a distraction. Maybe you don't have something terminated, or your resistor terminator has broken loose and it's creating a fault and not communicating properly, all the way to just basically a bad module. All right. And another thing is that you want to make sure that they are communicating at the same baud rate. So a couple things for you to look for, pretty easy. And I hope you found that this is helpful. These are, again, 1785 BCM is a module that we carry. We do have these in stock, and we do offer same-day shipping. So if this is something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.